हेलो फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल प्रतीक्षा मैथ्स क्लास. इन दिस लेक्चर वी शैल लर्न अबाउट डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ इनवर्स ट्रिगोनोमेट्री फंक्शंस. फॉर्मूलाज यू माइट हैव सीन, सो लेट्स हैव अ क्विक रिकॉल एट द डिफरेंशिएशन फॉर्मूलाज फॉर इनवर्स ट्रिगोनोमेट्री फंक्शंस. डिफरेंशिएशन ऑफ साइन इनवर्स एक्स इज 1/√1 माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर. And differentiation of cos inverse x is negative of that. It means -1/√1 - x². Derivative of tan inverse x is 1/1 + x² and derivative of cot inverse x is -1/1 + x². Derivative of sec inverse x 1/mod x √(x² - 1) and derivative of cosec inverse x is negative of that. It means -1/mod x √(x² - 1). We will have use of some other formulas also from the trigonometry that you have studied earlier. So let's have a quick recall on that formulas, specially which are useful in the differentiation of inverse trigonometry functions. Sin 2x is equal to 2 tan x divided by 1 + 10² x. Cos 2x is 1 - 10² / 1 + 10². Tan 2x is equal to 2 tan x divided by 1 - 10² x. I will suggest you to note down all these formulas because they will be useful in this lecture. So whenever we use them, you may easily see them. So you may pause this video and note down these formulas and then move ahead. We'll take examples to understand this concept. First example is find out derivative of tan inverse of 3x. So here f dash x is equal to d by dx of tan inverse of 3x. We have already seen the chain rule for derivatives. Whenever function inside a function is given, we need to apply that rule. So if you don't know chain rule, I will request you to go to the previous video of chain rule for differentiation and then you can continue this. So here outer function is tan inverse and the inner function is 3x. It means first we need to apply derivative of tan inverse, and in the formulas we have seen that derivative of tan inverse x is 1/1 + x². This is the formula. So using this formula, derivative of tan inverse 3x will be 1/1 + 3x² when x is given, it is 1 + x². When 3x is given, it will be 1 + 3x² into applying the chain rule. Since the derivative of tan inverse is over, now we have to find out derivative of 3x. So d by dx of 3x. 1/1 + 3x² as it is, and derivative of 3x is equal to 3. So here the differentiation process is over. For the simplification, we can write down 3 into the numerator and divide it by 1 + 3x². It means 9x². So this is simple. You just need to remember the formulas for derivative. Let's take another example. Find out dy by dx if y is equal to tan inverse of 2x divided by 1 - x². Now this example can be solved in two different ways. We'll see both of the methods one by one. So first, method one. Here I am going to use the formula that we have seen in the first slide about sin 2x, cos 2x and tan 2x. So if you remember, then tan 2x is equal to 2 tan theta divided by 1 - 10² θ. One of the formula was like this. So we are going to apply this formula here. We'll take x is equal to tan theta. And if we take x is equal to tan theta, then obviously theta is equal to tan inverse of x. Now substituting x is equal to tan theta everywhere, we get y is equal to tan inverse of 2 tan theta divided by 1 - 10² θ. And This is nothing but 10 of 2 theta. So this is equal to 10 inverse of 10 of 2 theta. Whenever inverse and the function comes together, they remove the effect of each other. So 10 inverse and 10 both will be removed because they are inverse of each other, and we left with 2 theta. So this is equal to 2 theta, and substituting theta is equal to 10 inverse x, we get 2 into 10 inverse of x. Why such substitution is required, you may have a question? Because we have to find out dy by dx, and if you want to differentiate with respect to x, then finally theta should be replaced by x, and theta is equal to 10 inverse x. So we are again converting back in terms of x. So what do we get? Y is equal to 2 into 10 inverse of x. Now we will differentiate both sides with respect to x, so that differentiation of y is dy by dx, 2 is constant as it is, and we know that differentiation of 10 inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. So this is dy by dx using the formula method. Here we are using substitution. We are taking x is equal to 10 theta to simplify this, and we are proceeding further. If you don't want to go with this method, there is another method where we will apply chain rule for derivatives. So this is 2 upon 1 plus x square. Okay, now we shall discuss the same example using another method, method of chain rule. So since y is equal to 10 inverse of 2x upon 1 minus x square, here two functions are present. The first outer side function is 10 inverse, and the second function, which is inside, it is 2x divided by 1 minus x square. So differentiating both sides with respect to x, we know that when we apply the chain rule, first outer function is differentiated, and differentiation of 10 inverse x is 1 upon 1 plus x square. So using the same concept, since we are having this in place of x, differentiation of 10 inverse of 2x divided by 1 minus x square is equal to 1 upon 1 plus whole bracket square. If x is present here, 1 plus x square. If bracket is present here, 1 plus bracket square. We are using the same formula for 10 inverse x. Now, according to chain rule, the differentiation of 10 inverse is over here. It will be multiplied with differentiation of inner function. It means d by dx of 2x upon 1 minus x square. Now see, we have to find out differentiation of this bracket, and here you can see that this is division of two functions. It means we need to proceed further with the division rule for the differentiation that we have discussed in our earlier video. So we will apply the same rule here, and together simultaneously we will simplify this term. So first let's see what is simplification of this. 1 divided by 1 plus, now we are taking square in numerator and denominator both. So numerator square will be 4x square, and denominator square will be 1 minus x square the whole square. And here we have to apply the division rule. You know the division rule. First keep denominator as it is into differentiation of numerator, minus numerator as it is into differentiation of denominator, divide by denominator whole square. So here simplifying further, this will be multiplied here. 1 minus x square we are taking as LCM, so this will be multiplied with 1. So 1 minus x square whole square plus 4x square whole divided by 1 minus x square whole square. And here 1 minus x square as it is, differentiation of 2x is 2, minus 2x as it is, differentiation of 1 is 0, and differentiation of minus x square is minus 2x divided by 1 minus x square whole square. Now here this will go to the numerator as per the fractions rule. So 1 minus x square whole square and divided by 1 minus x square square plus 4x square. 2 we are multiplying into the bracket, So this will be 2 minus 2x square and minus minus plus here. So this will be 2 into 2, 4, x into x, x square. So this is 4x square divided by 1 minus x square whole square. Now since this slide is changing, I will keep the last term as it is in the new slide. So this is just for your reference. It is same as the previous one. Okay, now here you can see that this term will be cancelled with this term because both are same. So both will be cancelled. So here we are having 1 and 1. Further, 2 minus 2x square and plus 4x square. 2 is as it is. But minus 2x square and plus 4x square, so it will be plus 2x square. And here, 1 minus x square whole square plus 4x square. Now, we will expand this using the square formula. We know that a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. A minus b square whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So here, this will be 1 square is equal to 1 minus sign as it is. 2 into first term into second term. It means 2 into 1 into x square, which is equal to 2x square. Plus last term square, x square whole square is x raised to 4 plus 4x square. And from here, we can take 2 common. So it will be 2 into 1 plus x square. Simplifying further, 1 upon, this is plus 4x square, this is minus 2x square. Plus 4x square and minus 2x square. So it will be plus 2x square. And this is as it is. Now here, again, using the square formula, this can be written as 1 plus x square the whole square. Because if you expand this, you will get the same. Any simplification is possible now? Obviously, 1 plus x square is here, and here we have 1 plus x square whole square. So, one time, 1 plus x square, 1 plus x square will be cancelled. So, in numerator, we left with only 2. And in denominator, we left with 1 plus x square. So, the answer is same as we have got in method 1. You can see that both examples are okay. You can solve the example using any of the method. But here, the simplification part is very lengthy. So if you will remember the formulas, then it will make your example easy. So in this video of math class, we have discussed the derivatives for inverse trigonometric functions. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.